Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making Christmas cookies, and they're pinwheel cookies. And they're very special cookies because they're actually brown sugar cookies, and they get the name pinwheel. Well, you'll see later why they get that. But we're going to start by just mixing up a dough, and it's going to be kind of normal, except instead of using white sugar, I'm using brown sugar. I have 1/2 cup of butter. This is just salted butter. You can use unsalted if you prefer. And it needs to be at room temperature, so you can mash it like this or even melt it if you like. I put this in the microwave and this is what came out. All I need to do is get it mixed up. It'll be going in the refrigerator and it will solidify again. So it needs to be in some form that you can mix. That's 1 stick or 1/2 cup of butter. So we got that. And we move down the line to our brown sugar, light brown sugar. And we need 1 cup of packed light brown sugar. Oops, I kind of sprayed some butter around here. We'll just mix those together with a fork. And you see how nice it is with the butter melted or almost melted? It can just easily go together with your brown sugar. Next we have eggs, but we're just going to put 1 egg, and I have some large eggs here. Just pick one here and I'll just crack it on the counter. There it goes. Next we have vanilla. Very few ingredients here, but they mingle together to make a very good cookie. We'll add one additional thing later on to half of our dough. There's a hint about the pinwheel. You need 1 teaspoon, this is a tablespoon measure, but I used 1 teaspoon measure so I wouldn't spill so much. And over here, we'll put that in. Now I want to use my mixer and blend this up, and then I'll be stirring in the flour, and that will be the last ingredient before this goes in the refrigerator. So let me get this done, and I'll be right back. And this is what you get when you blend all of those ingredients with a mixer. It's nice and fluffy, and it's ready to receive the flour. And we have self-rising flour that allows us not to worry about baking soda, baking powder, salt. It's all in here that you need, 2 cups. So I probably would add maybe half that and then give it a stir and then incorporate the other half into it. So let me take care of that. Then I'll come right back. I have the flour blended into my dough, and this is what it looks like. And what I want to do at this point is divide it into 2 parts. So I have sort of flattened it out into an oval shape, and I've got it about the same height all the way across. So I think if I take a knife and go down the middle, that would be about the easiest way for me to approximate the 2 halves of it. So I'm going to take 1/2 of it and just put it in a bowl. The other half gets something extra. And this is the key to making the pinwheel. You're going to have to mix in 2 tablespoons of cocoa. Just regular baking cocoa. It's not sweetened at all. So this is going to be the flavorful part of the pinwheel cookie. The very flavorful part. So I'm going to mix this around, and I'll come back when I have it in that fashion for the next bowl. Here's the half of the dough that I added the 2 tablespoons of cocoa to. And I'm just going to put it out in the other dish. And then what I'm going to do is use some plastic wrap and cover them both, put them in the refrigerator for an hour or so, and then I'll be able to roll them more easily than if they're at room temperature. If you want to start right now and roll them, you can. They may want to stick a little bit to your surface. But I'll be rolling these out, and then we will make pinwheels out of them. Here are our 2 bowls of cookie dough. And we have our brown sugar flavored cookie dough and our chocolate flavored cookie dough. Now, once you get these mixed up, you might want to refrigerate them. But if they are workable as they are, then just go ahead and put them on some wax paper. You'll want to sprinkle a little flour on your wax paper, and then you'll get out your brown sugar dough, and you might want to stretch that out a little bit before you put it down. And when you put it down, then place a little flour over the top and roll that out. Now over here I have another piece of wax paper, and I'll repeat the process with the chocolate. So let me get these rolled out, and then I'll come back with something like a rectangle of the brown sugar flavor and a rectangle over here of the chocolate flavor. When you get these two pieces of dough rolled out until they're about the same shape and size, then you're ready to move on to the next step. And you notice these are not done perfectly. They don't have sharp edges or anything, but we'll be trimming that off, so don't worry about that. So take one or the other, it doesn't really matter, and just take your wax paper and flip this so that one of them fits on top of the other. And once you flip it, you can remove the wax paper. It may be hard for you to move the dough itself, but that, again, really doesn't matter, because we basically want to get a rectangle of some size out of it. And at this point, we could go ahead and I think do the trimming and then remove the wax paper. So when you trim, you're going to think, well, try to get some of each flavor in, but if we don't, it's not any big problem. But you can get a fairly sharp side like that. Let me continue to trim, and I'll show you what we have next. So I have my two layers together and reasonably trimmed. They're not perfect, but what I want to do is roll this. I take the long side and roll it jelly roll fashion. And that's the way we're going to get our pinwheels. Here I am most of the way through, and I have used the wax paper to help me with the rolling. I just don't let it get caught under there. I keep pulling it forward. And then when we come close to the end, pull it out. And if it doesn't wind up a straight line, you might want to take a knife and cut until that line is straight. And then just move that away. Doesn't really matter if it ended up with that little extra bit. It wouldn't be a big problem. But now that we have it like this, our roll is complete. And what we need to do is wrap it and refrigerate it, or you can even freeze it at this point and get it out much later. I would like to trim off the ends so that they will look nice, and I can give you an idea of what this is going to look like. It's a pinwheel. And it will look better toward the center as compared to what you have here at the end. But each end should come off just for the sake of having something that looks nice and clean. And here we have our roll. We're ready to bake our cookies, and I've had this in the freezer for about a half hour, and it's very solid, so it probably doesn't need to be that long, but it does help you in cutting these uniformly. And I've already cut one off, and that is about 3/8 of an inch thick. So I'm going to try to make them all about that size, and then I will place them in a buttered baking pan or cookie sheet. Actually, I sprayed it with cooking oil spray, so if you prefer butter, that's fine. So I'm just going to go along here and cut each one of these. And you can see it's very easy to cut when you have cooled it off enough. And I will go ahead and put them in here. We'll put them in a 350-degree oven. They should bake for 12 to 15 minutes. I have just gotten my pinwheel cookies out of the oven, and you can see that this pan holds 20. You don't want to put them closer together, because then they would square off and that would spoil the circular effect. But you do want to remove them immediately once they're out of the oven. You want to get them off the pan and onto a cooling rack, and then let them cool a bit, and then we'll arrange them nicely on a plate. These cookies have cooled a bit, and I think we can go ahead and transfer them to a nice plate. I've got a Christmassy plate. I'm going to cover it up right now, but I'm just using my hands to transfer them over. They are a little bit on the brittle side, so you don't want to be too rough with them, but they're not all that fragile. They're not that breakable. But you can go ahead and put them on the plate. These did take 11 minutes to bake, and I did have enough dough left over to make as many again. So that would be 20 here plus 20 more. It would make 40 cookies like this. And this is a wonderful project for you to do with your children, and you can leave them out on Christmas Eve for Santa with a nice tall glass of milk. Hope you enjoy them.